So we're continuing the same subtitle in this slide, Mexican-American War still. First, let's talk about the leader on the Mexican side, that is Santa Anna. So Santa Anna was previously involved in the Texas Revolution. If you've studied Texas history at all, you probably recognize his name. He was the commander against the revolting Texan forces. He was actually expelled from Mexico after that and then brought back to Mexico by the U.S. with the understanding that he would then kind of owe the U.S. a favor and want to help them and would then grant them the treaty that they wanted, ceding some of the land to the United States. However, he broke his promise and did not give them that treaty, and so he turns into a major adversary again during this war. Now, the U.S. attack plan comes in three parts, with three major commanders leading those three different areas. So first, we have General Zachary Taylor. Yes, the future president, Zachary Taylor. He is stationed on the Rio Grande. He's supposed to take northern Mexico, kind of all that area around where he's already stationed. This actually isn't a very glorious place to be during this war, but Polk is a little bit worried that Taylor is going to try to run for president and try to kind of overshadow Polk. And so he doesn't want Taylor's glory overshadowing his own, so he puts him in kind of an unglorious spot in the war. Then we have General Kearny. He's going to deal with taking New Mexico. That's not just the state of New Mexico, but a lot of that territory that we consider the Mexican Cession on our map. And of course, Fremont is still over there revolting in California. And then finally, General Winfield Scott. General Winfield Scott was the kind of the premier general of this time. He's supposed to be involved with the glorious command of taking Mexico City. So these three guys are supposed to take the different parts of the Mexican territory and hopefully subdue Mexico with that. A lot of future Civil War commanders actually started in this war. So we'll see some of them on a future slide, but Robert E. Lee, George McClellan, Ulysses S. Grant, future president of the Confederacy, Jefferson Davis, all get their start as soldiers or minor commanders during the Mexican-American War before they move on to being major Civil War commanders. Then we get to the actual battle. So we have this three-pronged attack plan, but what actually happens? Well, Taylor is very successful in northern Mexico. He's a pretty good general, and so he finishes up there pretty quickly. Kearny ends up going to California rather than staying in New Mexico and helping out a little bit in California. And Taylor eventually sends a lot of his soldiers down to help take Mexico City, which falls in September of 1847. So, in the end, Taylor does get a little bit of that glory that Polk was trying to deny him after all.